Okay, Selenium IDE, RC and WebDriver. When we come to the point of Selenium IDE, it's a just a record and playback tool. It supports only Mozilla Firefox browser. It is less secure. It is an add-on to Mozilla Firefox. Support Mozilla Firefox browser. Okay. Now what we are going to see is we are going to install the Selenium IDE and see what are the problems we face with the while installing with Selenium IDE. Yesterday I have just installed Selenium IDE with all my compatible versions. But in your system, everything won't be compatible enough, right? You will be using different versions of Firefox browser, all those things. What problems you will face? How to solve all those problems? We can see now. Installation of Selenium. Installation of Selenium IDE. First, let us see the installation of Selenium IDE. Okay, as I said, the Selenium IDE, it is an add-on to the Mozilla Firefox browser, right? We can install only in Mozilla Firefox browser. First, open Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to SeleniumHQ.org. Go to the website called SeleniumHQ.org. Just a minute. Go to SeleniumHQ.org. Open Mozilla Firefox, go to SeleniumHQ.org, click on download. Then you will find many subheadings like Selenium Standalone Server, Internet Explorer Driver, Selenium Client. Like this, you will find many subheadings. Under that, find Selenium IDE subheading. Under that, find Selenium IDE. Here, if you click on Firefox, it will go here, but it will show us error message. This add-on requires a new version, at least 56.0. But which version of Firefox I am using? I am using 46th version. That's why this is not compatible enough. Okay, in that case, what you can do is go to SeleniumHQ.org/download. Under Selenium IDE, you will find previous IDE versions. Click on this. Based upon your compatibility, this particular add to Firefox button will be enabled. For me, this is enabled. I can click on this, click on install. Okay, I suggest you also to use 46th version. Okay, because going further, you will face little bit of problems. How to solve that, I will let you know. But once we start with Selenium WebDriver, we can go with the updated version of Firefox browser. Right now, try to use 46.0 version of Firefox browser and start installing Selenium IDE. Up to 56 it supports, and you can, based upon your version, you can do that. Where can you download the different versions? We can see that also now. Okay, now I have installed the Selenium IDE. Click on this add to Firefox button and install now Selenium IDE. Click on this add to Firefox and click on install now. Selenium IDE will get installed. Once you install Selenium IDE, you will get this icon, Selenium IDE icon. And go to tools, you will get Selenium IDE. This is how I can confirm that my Selenium IDE has been successfully installed. Okay. Now I have my Selenium IDE. But the problem with different versions, where can I download the different versions of Firefox? If you want, you can take down this running notes. No notes for this, where to download different versions. Go to filehippo.com. Normally, if I want general softwares like VLC Media Player or Firefox or Chrome or any other browsers, right? I use this website. This website contains all the collections of softwares. Filehippo.com. Go to filehippo.com. Here I have browsers. I'll click on browsers. filehippo.com and click on browsers. Filehippo.com and click on browsers. You will find all the browsers here. Okay. Once you go to the browsers, you will get Firefox. Don't directly click on this download. If you click on this download, right, it will download the latest version. Don't go with this. Go to this Firefox. You will find all the versions here. Once you come down, somewhere you have older versions, view more, right? Click on this so that you will get all the versions of Firefox. Now 62.0 beta has been started 2 days ago. Okay. Now, if you come down, you will find 61, 60. If you go to the next page, you will find 59. Or else if you go to next, somewhere you will find 46. Hello? Rita? I am in class, Rita. Can I call you after class, Rita?
You are saying that you are not in the class, Sandeep and other people.
When did they tell? Sandeep and Pradeep, are you there? So Sandeep and Pradeep. Hello?
Yes.
Sandeep. What about Pradeep? Pradeep, are you there?
Yes,
Rita, they are there, Rita. Venkat is not there, that's it. Yeah. I will add you tomorrow, Rita. A little bit busy. You said to her that you are not in the class, it seems. That's why she has called me again.
No. Okay. 7:33 in our time.
Okay, fine.
She asked us.
Okay.
Yes, the class started, but I replied.
Okay, fine. Not a problem. If you go to the next page, Mousami, please mute your mic, Mousami. Yeah. Go to filehippo.com, browsers. Under browsers, you will click on the Firefox. You will find all, under that, click on view more. You will get all the versions of Firefox. If you want 59, you can go with. Now I am in the fourth page. Somewhere if you go to the 23rd page, you will get 46.0. Click on this and click on download this version so that you will get a .exe file. Okay, uninstall your latest version if you have and install this. Okay, once you install this and once you restart your machine, automatically it will update again, right? That's why always prefer to stop the updates of Firefox. It is preferred to stop the updates of Firefox. Where can you stop the updates of Firefox? Where can you stop the updates of Firefox? Go to Tools, go to Options, take down these known notes for this. These are some general things what you have to know by yourself. Okay, where to stop the updates of Firefox? Go to Tools, go to Options. Go to Advanced. Go to Update tab and click on Never Check for Updates. It will not check. When you restart your machine, it will not check for the updates. Or else, whenever you restart your machine, right, it will go to the latest version again. But right now, we are going to use 46th version. How to work with different versions, all those things we can see later in the upcoming chapters. Okay. Right now, I am going to use 46th version, which you can download from filehippo.com under browsers, under Firefox, under older versions, Vuemo. There you can go to the different versions and download the different versions. Right? Now, I have downloaded Selenium IDE and I have installed Selenium IDE in my machine. Okay, this is what I can successfully tell that I can install the, I had installed the Selenium IDE. Now, do you have any doubts in installing Selenium IDE? Those who have errors, now can you rectify yourself? Install, but it is not showing. Okay, for few of them, they have got the error that they have installed, but they are unable to see that here. I mean, in this Selenium IDE, or else they are unable to see that here also. And don't come and complain that I am unable to see these bar. This is menu bar. This would have disabled by default. Go here, right click and menu bar. Okay, you will get this menu bar. Okay, right click here so that you will get this menu bar. Go here, or else. Somewhere here if you go also, you will get this. Okay, no need. Just go here and get this menu bar. Now go to Tools. Open Selenium IDE. It will open Selenium IDE. If you don't get this icon here, you will get it in the Tools. Okay. Still, if you have installed many of them, they will not be getting the Selenium IDE option. If you are not getting, what you do, go to Tools, go to Add-ons. Here you have Add-ons, right? Click on this Add-ons and go to this Extensions tab. Here the Selenium IDE, this will be disabled. You will get an Enable button. Click on this Enable, then you will get it. Okay, go to Tools, Add-ons. Add-ons would have been disabled. If you enable that, you will get it. That's it. This is just an add-on. Selenium IDE is just an add-on. These are the normal problems what you will be getting when you are working with Selenium IDE or RC or WebDriver. Yeah, tell me clearly. Yeah. Which one? This one. You are using the latest version of Firefox browser, it seems. 56, it won't get it in that. There is something called a small icon. If you click on that icon, you will get all these options. No, actually these options are inside one icon there. There is a small icon, folder icon. Normally if you go to the Word document, right? If you go to the Word document, earlier it is file like that, everything is there. Now they have changed that to a icon, window icon. Do you know that? In the same way they have changed this also. See here, you have to click on this to get all these things. Earlier, you used to get it in the menu bar, right? In the same way it is done in Selenium IDE also. Nothing difference. Okay? But you will get all those options inside that. Not a problem. And one more thing, we will not use the Selenium IDE anywhere. No need to worry about that much. Okay? Starting from tomorrow's topics onwards, we will be learning important topics. And Monday's topic onwards, we will be starting with core concepts. Okay, tomorrow's class is also important, but Monday's class onwards, we will be starting with core concepts. Now, I have installed the Selenium IDE. Can you tell me the procedure for Selenium IDE? Installation of Selenium IDE? Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to Selenium. hq.org, click on download. If you have not taken down, take down this. Under Selenium IDE subsection, Selenium IDE subsection, click on previous IDE versions, then click on previous IDE versions, click on add to Firefox, then click on install. That's all about installation of Selenium IDE. Now we are going to start working with the Selenium IDE. Okay, I'll let you know what are the drawbacks of the Selenium. Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to Tools, Selenium IDE. Keep your browser and your Selenium IDE parallelly, so that you will come to know what. See, this is the record button, right? I have opened Mozilla Firefox browser and I have opened Selenium IDE. This is the record button. Now, before starting Selenium IDE, we need some application to automate. Everyone, wherever you watch the YouTube videos, they will be letting you know about Gmail, how to automate Gmail login. Let us try with some different application, live applications. Okay, that's why what I have chosen is, I have chosen an application called demo.actytime.com. Okay, did you everyone try opening this? Yes. Demo.actytime.com. This is an application where anyone can view that. Don't open www.actytime.com or https://www.demo.actytime.com. Don't do all those combinations and all. Just type demo.actytime.com. You will get this application. What is this application is all about in the sense? In a company, for example, if you are working in a company called TCS, there will be hundreds of projects in the TCS. in one campus itself, there will be at least some 10 to 15 projects which it will be running. 15 to 20 different clients there will be. Each and every client will be having different login times and logout times. Everyone will be entering and exiting in a common gate. Right? They need to calculate the time of each and every, whether each and every employee had spent 8 hours. They need some calculations to do all those things, right? They cannot store each and every time and calculate everything. That's why this application is meant for. Okay. How to access this application, I will let you know later. The username for this is admin and password for this is manager. Click on login. Once you log in, you will get different tabs here. Once you log in, you will get different tabs. That is tasks tab, reports tab, users tab. You can send reports. You can create reports. You can create customers. You can create new users. All those things we can see later. Okay. As of now, we know how to log in into the application. And if you click on log out, it will log out of the application. Log out of the application. Now, okay, let's start with this automating the login scenario of this application. Let's start. We have just yesterday recorded and playback, right? We didn't save the test case. If you have saved yesterday, the test case, whatever we have recorded yesterday, if you have saved that, we would have used that today. But I didn't save that. I've just, whatever I have taught you now, I have taught you yesterday also. But I didn't save the test case. What we are going to do now, I will save the test case, do the repetitions again, do all those things we can do now. Okay. Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Go to Selenium ID. Open Selenium ID. Check whether your record is in on or not. Is it in on? Now recording. Click to stop recording, which means that now whatever you do in the browser, it will get recorded here. It will get recorded here. I am going to open demo.actitime.com. I am going to open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin. See, it is getting recorded there, right? Enter manager. It is getting recorded there, right? Click on login. It is getting recorded. Okay. If I stop recording and if I do something here, stop recording and I am trying to do logout, it cannot. It is not recording here, right? Because I have stopped recording. That's right. Now, I'll close this browser, open a new browser. And if I try to run this, this button is used to run. I have recorded a test case. This is one test case now. I have recorded one test case. Now, if I run using this button, this is play current test case. If you run this, it will open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin manager, click on log. It is doing very quickly. You are unable to see the speed of execution, right? Why because, let me run from the beginning again. Why because I have kept this in the fast mode. To run the test case in fast mode, I will slow down the speed of execution. And if I run this once again, it will open this demo.actitime.com. Enter admin, enter manager, click on login. Done, right? Now, log out. Can I do that from once again now? I'm not saving this. Let us save later. Go to tools, open Selenium ID, check whether record is in on or not. It is not mandatory that you want to maximize the Selenium ID and keep it. You can minimize this and tell your friend to open this, open his icicibank.com. Tell your friend to open icicibank.com. Tell him to enter his username, password, and tell him to click on login button. And tell him to go out of your room and open this and check. You will get his password here clearly. Admin and manager, which is hidden there, you are getting that password here, right? Is it secured application? Is Selenium ID secured? Password is getting hidden in the browser, but it is getting displayed in your Selenium ID. Very, very less secured. You can do this. You can try. You can tell your friend to open his Gmail account. You can get his password for sure. Okay. It is not at all preferred. Not at all preferred anywhere. to use such a kind of tools? If it is displaying your passwords, all those things, who will use it? And one more drawback we have found is it supports only Firefox. Now, if I were, I mean, it is just a record and playback tool. Now, let me save this test case. Go to, I have recorded one test case. Let me stop this. Stop this. Save this test case. Go to file. Go to file here. Save test case is there, right? Go to save test case. I am going to create a new folder for your batch. For each and every batch, I will create a new folder under class. I will create a new folder. All the programs till the end of your class, all the programs will be there under this particular folder. At the end of the class, you will be ending up with some 50 to 60 programs, Java programs and WebDriver programs. All those things will be there inside this folder. Last day, I will zip this folder and I will send it to everyone so that it will be helpful for you. That's why I'm creating this folder. And file name, I will name it as login. Save. I saved this file as login. Right? Go home today. Come back tomorrow again. I'm coming back tomorrow again. Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Okay, open Mozilla Firefox browser, go to tools, open Selenium IDE. Yesterday I have recorded one test case, right? Just before 5 minutes, I have recorded one test case and saved the test case, right? Go to file, open. Open this login.html. It has got it. What the test case I have recorded, some login steps I have recorded, right? Now slow down the speed of execution and run this. It will open this demo.actitime.com. Enter admin, manager, click on login. You will be getting. It has logged in. Do you have any doubts in recording, saving the test case and playing back the test case? Just take down the notes. How to record a test case and how to play back the test case. Going further, I will be giving small steps to you. You can practice those things for today's homework. Yeah.
For saving the test case, yeah. Normally we'll have saving SharePoint or something, a repository.
Well, however you want, you can do that. That's up.
Industry standard, what they will be doing?
No, normally they will not use Selenium IDE at all, first of all.
Okay,
we can create a folder and just we'll first put it into our local repository. Okay. Then we will use SVN or Git and push it to the server. Oh. That is how we do normally in industry. Earlier days, when they used to use the Selenium IDE, they used to do like that.
So
SVN or Git, some other repository tools they will use it. That's what we'll see later. I mean, last few classes we'll see about that also as well. Okay. Next we are going to see that. There are 8 element locators, right? It takes randomly few things. Next we will see how, from tomorrow's class onwards, that is what we are going to see there. About element locators, we will cover about next 4 more days of topic. Completely on element locators. Why it takes ID, why it takes name, all those things. Okay, now. Let me create a new test case. Same test case, I need to log in and log out. Right click, new test case. Can you tell me how to record a test case now? Check whether record button is in on or not. Click to now recording, click to stop recording. Now open demo.actitime.com. Open demo.actitime.com. Enter admin manager. Then click on login. After logging in, I need to click on logout. That's a complete cycle. I didn't cover the complete cycle earlier. Now I am going to complete the cycle. Logout. Login and logout is done here. Now stop the test case. Now if I run, it has to run perfectly, right? Login and logout. Check whether it runs fine or not. Opens demo.actitime.com. Enters admin manager. Click on login. And it has thrown an error here. Why? Logout link is not found. But logout link is here. Why? First, it has opened the browser. had it done correctly? Yes. It has entered admin in the username text box. Done. It has entered manager in the password box. Done. What up? Oh. Enter manager in the password box. Then it has clicked on login. That also is done. And while it is clicking on logout link, it is throwing an error. Why? Can you guess that? Anyone? Yes. Correct. See, after logging in, this will not stop for each and every statement. It continuously executed. It continuously got executed. But the problem is, after logging in, it is taking some time to load the page there. It is taking some time to load the page. But I didn't wait there. In between login and logout, did it wait anywhere? No. I didn't wait even for a single second also. It will keep on executing continuously one after the other. That is the problem. After logging in, I need to wait for... Now if I click on this, if you double click on this statement, that particular statement will get executed. Double click on this, that particular statement will get executed. Now it is executing. Because the page has loaded and the element is there. Logout link element is there. It is able to identify that element and click on that element. But when it is executing continuously, there is a problem that it is taking some time to load the page. How to solve that error? Normally, after recording the test case, we need to go through each and every step and see where the wait time is there and increase the time and do all those things. Okay? Now, after logging in between these two steps, after logging in, I need to wait for some time. So that what you can do is, in the login button is there, right? Single click on the statement. See if you... Execute each and every statement. Double click. That particular statement will get executed. If you double click on this, that particular admin has been came. If you double click, now manager will be posted in that password box. If I double click on this, double click is nothing but execute that particular statement in Selenium ID. Now if I click on logout, it will log out of that particular statement. Now after clicking on login, I need to wait for some time. So that single click here, so that you can come and edit the statement here. Click and wait. Use click and wait instead of click. Earlier it is click, right? Now what I made, click and wait. So that it will click and it will wait for the page to be loaded. Okay. It will wait for a maximum of 30 seconds. How to change the time? Can I change the time? All those things we can see now. Okay. By default, it will change. It will wait for 30 seconds. Even though if it doesn't loads in 30 seconds, right? It will come to the next line and it will throw you error and it will come out. Okay. Now if I run this, let me run this now. Open demo.actytime.com. Enter admin manager. Click on login. It will wait. It didn't throw any error here, right? And it will click on logout and it has came out. It didn't throw any error at all. Because after clicking on login, I am waiting here for some time. I am waiting. Click and wait I have used. Okay. That is, I am synchronizing my application. Synchronizing the application with wait. Okay. By adding page load timeout. That is called page load timeout. See, by default, I said that it will wait for a maximum of 30 seconds. But if the page loads in 3 or 4 seconds, the 5th second, it comes to the next line of execution. That is called auto-synchronization. Auto-synchronization is there inbuilt in Selenium IDE. Auto-synchronization is there in inbuilt in Selenium IDE. Go to... See, if you want to... imagine that your application is very slow. You are using some VPN access in your office or you are using some... or else your internet is very slow. Due to that, your application is loading very slowly, but still you want to continue automating that. You want to increase the time value. How can you increase the default timeout value? Go to options. If you want, you want to take running notes only. Go to options. No notes for today's class. From tomorrow, you will get complete notes. Only for today's class, you don't have notes because it's not a much important topic. Go to options. Go to options. Go to options again. Go to options again. Here you have default timeout value, right? Here you have a default timeout value. Any doubts? What you? Any problem? Okay. You can take it later. Leave it. Default timeout value is there, right? Here, they have given 30,000 milliseconds. It's very blur, right? I'll make it paint. Here it is showing default timeout value as 30,000 seconds. Right? Increase this time however you want. If you want for 1 minute, make it as 60,000 seconds. If you want 2 minutes, 12,000 seconds. Like that, you change it according to yourself. It is taking in milliseconds and click on OK. That's it. So that it will work based upon that particular time what you have mentioned there. That is how to change the default timeout value. Take down heading as how to change the default timeout value. How to change the default timeout value. So that you can rectify all the errors what you find in this Selenium IDE. Done. Next. This is how to record a test case and how to play back the test case. Now, what I am going to do here is, it is recording. Until now, I have recorded, right? Now, I am not going to record the test case. I am going to write the test cases by my own. Okay? Don't record the test case. Start writing the test cases now. Okay? Let me start writing the new test case. I am not going to record anymore. I am going to write the test case. What is the first step what you are going to do here? Anyhow, browser will open. What is the next step? I need to open the URL. Which URL? Demo.actytime.com is the URL what you are going to open. See, single click here. Single click on the first statement. The command to open the URL is open. Open is the command to open the URL. And in the base URL, put the URL which you are going to work. Now if you run this step, it will open the URL. It has opened the demo.actytime.com URL. Open command and in the base URL put the URL. It will open the URL. If you want this extension URL, you can put it in target or else just leave it also, not a problem. That's it, it will open the URL. What is the next step what you are going to do? Enter the username. Where? Can I enter in my notepad? No. Where I want to enter? In the username text box. If I want to enter the username in the username text box, what are the two steps what I have to do? See, first, I need to identify this username text box. Then I want to perform action on it. If I want to identify the username text box, I need to use a concept of element locators. I need to use a concept of element locators to identify the element. In Selenium, there are 8 element locators. To do any automation activity, you will be following only two steps. One is identifying the element, and second is performing action on it. Okay, these are the two steps what you will be doing. To identify the elements, you will use element locators. In Selenium, there are 8 element locators. What are those? ID is very important. Take down this if you have not taken down. ID, name, link text, XPath, CSS selector, class name, tag name, partial link text. Don't miss the order also. Order is also very important. Partial link text. Okay. These are the 8 element locators available in Selenium. Okay. Now, what I am going to do here is, first, my goal is here, the second step is, I need to type something here in this username text box. First, I have opened the browser here. Second step, I need to type admin in this username text box. If you want to type, the command is type. type is the command. Target is where you are going to type. You are going to type in the username text box. But this, it will not allow you to just mention here as username. What you have to do is, you want to give the element locator of that particular element. What is the element locator of this element? Can I use ID? Can I use name? You don't know which one. Don't use like that. Right click on this element. How to identify the element? Right click. Inspect element with Firebug. If you are not getting that inspect element with Firebug option, I will let you know how to get that later. Okay. Right click. Inspect element with Firebug. This is the source code of that element. This is the source code of that particular element. Are you getting this? Okay. Any element, it will start with tag name. Anything which is starts with angular brace is the tag name. Input is the tag name for this username text box. ID equal to username is one attribute. ID equal to username is one attribute. Class equal to text field. Class is one attribute. Type is one attribute. Value is one attribute. Name is one attribute. Placeholder is one attribute. Each and every attribute will have an attribute value as well. That is how an element will be built normally. Tomorrow we will see in detail about how to build different elements in a web page. Okay, so that we can see more clearly. Right now, whatever the element we have, we can go through that. Do you have ID for this element? Yes. If you have ID, use ID. ID equal to username. I can use that one. Here, type. Where I need to type? I need to type in the ID equal to username. It understands the element locator only. It doesn't understand your language, username, password or anything. ID equal to username. And value is nothing but what you are going to type. You are going to type as admin, right? Double click on that. That will get executed. Okay. Have you understood? I have identified the element and performed action. That is typing action. Okay. In the same way, I need to type something in the password box. That is my next goal, right? Can you tell me what is the command I have to do here?
Type.
Target is nothing but where you are going to type in the password box. How to identify the element locator of this? Last bench, guys, please. Right click. Inspect element with Firebug. What are the different attributes what it has? It has class, type, class equal to text field, PW field. Class attributes value is text field, PW field. Type attribute we have, value attribute we have, name attribute we have, and placeholder attribute we have. Okay, fine. Okay, this is the source code. Yeah, I'll do that. This is the source code. Okay, this is what we have. ID, sorry, we don't have, we have class, we have type, we have value, we have name, and we have placeholder. These are the attributes what it has. Are you getting this? Do you have ID attribute here? Do you have ID attribute?
No.
If you don't have ID, which is the next element locator what I said you to use?
Name.
I need to use name. Do you have name?
Yes.
Look for the element whether you have ID. If you have ID, use ID. See, most of them, those are working now still in Selenium, they don't follow this order. Okay, if they are not following this order, finally they will lose somewhere. I am sure for that. Okay, follow the order. ID, name. In this case, what I can use name equal to PWD. Name equal to PWD. What value I need to pass here?
Manager.
Done, right? Double click on this. It is entering. Now, next step. I need to click on login button, right? Use command click. Click and wait. Okay. If you want to click on target, pass the element locator there. Then execute that. The element locator of this is, we have ID for this. I know that. I can use this ID. I will let you know about that clearly about the element locators going further. Now if I click on this, it will get executed there. Admin manager, click on login. Got it? This is how to write the test case by yourself. At the background of when it is recording the test case, it will execute. Now first, I have identified ID. I have identified name. Now you know how to identify the elements, right? First, you will right click, inspect element with Firebug. You will get the source code of that. From the source code, try to take ID. If not ID, go for name. Now, I need to identify this ActiTime INC link. I need to identify this ActiTime INC link. How can you identify this ActiTime INC link? Right click, inspect element with Firebug. What are the attributes what it has? A is not an attribute, that's a tag name. Anything which starts with... Okay, let me copy this and paste it in the notepad. This is the source code of that. Okay. Anything which starts with open angular brace is a tag name. Other things are attributes here. What are the attributes what it has? It has target, href. That's it. Nothing beyond that. Okay. In this case, do you have ID?
No.
Do you have name? If you don't have both name and ID and name, what is the next element locator what you will be using? Link text. Link text can be used only for links, not for other elements. Link text can be used only for links, not for other elements. Okay. Is it a link to identify the link text? Yes. Link will start with A tag. That is the identification for you. Link will start with A tag. No need to take down anything about that, because tomorrow we are going to see in detail how to build a web page. If you know that right, identifying the elements becomes very easy for you. It's not our job of building the web page. Developer is going to build the web page. Okay, we are testers. But if you know how the knowledge of how to build a web page, identifying the elements becomes very, very easy. It doesn't take hardly more than 1 hour to build a web page. Okay, tomorrow we can build a web page with different elements, not with the same kind of elements. So that we will come to know each and every element, how it is built. So that if you know how that element is built, identifying the elements becomes very easy for us. Okay, tomorrow's topic, what we are going to learn is not our job in our office, but most of the Selenium engineers fails to identify the element because they don't have enough knowledge in how the elements are built. That's why what we are going to do tomorrow's class is, we are going to start building the web page. Okay, today what you do is go home, install the Selenium IDE, record few test cases, write few test cases, write some test cases by yourself, and you will find difficulty while you are writing the test case. Just leave it there. That's enough up to that. Tomorrow we are going to start building the web page. Before that, I said you today, I will give you the course content, right? In the first page of your notebook, take down the index, whatever I am going to give. Some 38 classes of contents, whatever I am going to give. So that going after each and every topic, you can tick the topics. It's the first page of your notebook. You should have this. Yesterday, we have learned basics of testing and automation. Today's class, we have learned about Selenium IDE. Tomorrow, we'll like this day-to-day content. Whatever we are going to see, everything is there here. Okay, totally 38 topics are there, where 32 is divided into 2 and 12 topic is divided into 2. Okay, take down this 38 topics. Each and every day topic, it will take one. Each and every topic will take on an average of 1.5 hours. Okay, few topics I will complete in this topic, I can complete in 15 minutes itself. Few topics, it will take many days, not only 2 or 3 days, it will take more than that. But on an average, it is divided 1.5 hour of basis. Okay, Java topics initially we will look into 3 days only. Later on, again, when we start with Selenium WebDriver, we will see in detail each and every topic because we need to know the correlation between Java and WebDriver. Okay, that's why take down this content in your notebook, first page of your notebook, because if I miss 1 or 2 days, any one topic in between, any small topic also, you can remind me. You will be having a clear roadmap, how much percentage we have completed the course, all those things. That's why take down in the first page of your notebook. From this topic onwards, you cannot miss even a single topic. Until this, I can accept it. If you are not in yesterday's class also, you can cope up. From Monday's class onwards, if you are there, you can get on easily. But don't miss even a single class from this topic onwards. Everything is important. Yesterday and today, as I said, we'll have only 1 hour of session. From tomorrow onwards, tomorrow we'll take 1.5 hour. It will take nearly exactly 1.5 hour to complete tomorrow's class, because we want to build a web page. It will take some time. That's why. If you are taking any leaves, please let me know so that. Who is Leela Krishna here? Leela Krishna. Who is your friends? There are batch of 3 people, right? Who is one more? The one who had referred you. Oh, you have referred all 3, right? No, you have referred both. Okay, fine. I need to know your names exactly. Yesterday when I'm... And so you're done with this, don't move immediately, because I have problems with many of your email IDs. That's why. Take down this. Yeah, little, just a minute. Surya is not there. Murali is not there. Priyanka, one more Priyanka. Who is Amit's wife here? Amit's. Your name? Archana. Okay. Kavya? Is there anyone named Kavya? Manimala? Here. Swati, you are here. Yeah, I'll come, sir. I'll come, sir. Mosumi Srinivas. Okay, fine.